Well, today I'm going to paint this. This is a little cafe, a little tea shop in Rye. I've actually been to this this place, and it's incredible. It's tiny, it's small, but it's been there for hundreds of years, apparently. Little cobbled little lane off one of the streets in Rye, and I like it because it's got lots of colour. Also, I've got some knowledge of the place, so it will create a little bit of memory for me. But we've got some lovely earthy colours in the middle here, and some nice terracotta red colours on the top. And of course, we've got the perspective. We've got to get the vanishing point. It's off here, and the lines coming in like this. So we've got to try and get the drawing right. I've got a nice lot of colour. And the little flower basket there, a nice shape, and the sign, and the white, greens. Got this little gravel, and the little flint stones there, a little table there, a little tea table, and various greens, lighter yellowy greens here, and more darker greens, more intensified to the front of our picture. So let's get on and see what I can make of that. I'm drawing with this is a sketching water-soluble graphite. So I'm going to have a start with this anyway and see how we get on. But of course, then when I put water on it, it will dissolve somewhat into my painting, which is probably a good plan as long as I don't do it too soon. So I get my line coming down this way, the roof line, and out here comes vanishing point here. Then we've got our little shrub and hedge coming down this way in our foreground. And to what extent do I do detail? This is the question that you've got to ask yourself. Is the path coming this way? A little curve on it there. It disappears, and it's probably coming down here. And at this point, should come off like this. To give some degree of realism. And out here, the perspective, we've got the other chimney on this other cottage, which is sitting here. Window in this vanishing point here, that's somewhat hidden by our bush. Below this we have another window. Pretty much comes down to our gate. So this is just a rough little too far there. Yes, it should come about there. To the right of this window, let's get some suggestion of the frame of the window panes in. Make it a little real. just come across like this, so I get some idea of it. Chair and the oval, all that little coffee table slabs like this. Getting a little closer as they recede. Yeah, let's get this fence down. It's quite a feature. And about there, I've got the major structure of it. Cotter colour on this upper level. And then they go somewhat different colour. They go in the sort of umber. These are windows. We can do all that. Mustn't do too much with this water soluble in case I end up with a very muddy picture. And just to the right of that, we've got another window with a nice curve. There's a hard edge along there where the tiles finish. And then we've got a nice little curve there where we've got this window coming right down. Here. That again is hidden by some lovely shrubbery and baskets, flowers. Old bush there, nice little privet. Along here we've got nice little flags, little flagstones. So I might see if I can give some attention to that so we can get some nice colours. Darker towards the bottom here. Finally, I think I need to try and get this lovely sign. Of course, this little advertising is coming across here. So let's start with our, so come like that. In like this, How is that attached into the wall there? Various structures, I think, coming. Oh, I can see, yes, it is bolted to this structure here. I think that's enough for the moment, and we could press on with some colour. We can add more detail to it if we wish. So let's get, I've got the clean water. Now I'm going to go for my number, like a squirrel brush here, number 6 squirrel brush. So we'll put a little bit of water, dampen this down like this. Am I still recording? Yes, I am. Right. Get that a little damp. Not very much sky showing here, but I need to. Oh, I can see the graphite is going to definitely run. So I'll have to see how we deal with that as we go. And of course, watercolour dries considerably lighter. Considerably lighter after it dries. Therefore, I need to make a little pool. It's a nice summer day, so I think we'll go for a fairly strongish. Wow, that is a bit strong, isn't it? But as you see, it's bleeding down here. There we go. Come down. So we've got some holes behind our hedge. You see a bit of sky protruding through it. I think what I'm going to do is lift out a little bit as well, because I want to have a little bit of sky showing. Got some tissue that I'm holding here, just by my palette, and let's lift it out to make it interesting. Is that enough? Just keep it damp and wipe it best you can there. Right, I'm going to leave it at that. Then I'm going to put in a little light red. I think I'll go for there. A little terracotta. Got a nice little red for that. Again, I'm staying with my squirrel brush, but I think I'll make it a little smaller. I have a smaller one. Got a 6 here. These are a pointed wash. Number 4. So I'm going to try and get a little reddish colour to put in. Right. Got some light red there, sort of, call it light red, but it's a somewhat brownie or terracotta colour. And I'm going to just sweep in colour down to not much more than that window now, because it goes a different colour then. doesn't matter if I leave a few whites showing. It's a nice feature of watercolour. And down here, I also have a lightish red colour, but I'm using a little less paint here. Just try to keep it light. Could get a little bit darker for these. This section. There's a lot of smidges of dark and light in it actually. Let's paint around my sign. And create some illusion of the tiles. This little Dollaroni squirrel bush has got very nice little tip on it, which will allow you to create some pointed little marks, which might suggest some tiles coming along like this. So this is fairly loose interpretation. Boards down with, I think I might, I could use a little bit of these darker colours while I have them to hand. We'll come down here somewhat darker down here. Let's get a bit of green in so we can block out some of this. Put in a little see a little bit of the sky poking through there. So we want that. There's a bit of sap green. But in fact, can put a little bit up there. Then it comes right down here, jutting in here. So I can try and create a variety of greens. Got a little bit of cadmium yellow here, mixed with a bit of Hooker's green. A little darker towards the... A little bit of blue, perhaps, to make it a bit darker. Bit of ultramarine. Hookers. Give us a few bits of colour. Dab them in like this. Can create some nice colours. As I say, they've got some sort of yellows in it as well. Because it is a nice... It's a nice summery day. There were some nice warm colours. Right. And again, we've got a nice little privet there. I think I've got a little bit dark at the bottom there. And I have a darker there as well. I can drop a bit of blue in it. Right. Actually comes down to the end of our picture here. Right. Now let us get and do some of this. These little edges here. Now should I think I change my brush in a moment. I think I've got a nice little round number 8 Dalaroni, which will give me a little bit more control over those little boards that are stuck on the front of that. So here it is. Put my hand on it, that's it. Yes, it's a number 8 round. Can you see that? Number 8 round. The princely sum of $3.99. It's a really good brush. Dalaroni. Let's get a little blue going. It's not too bright. It's a sort of cobalty blue. Cobalt, a sort of not bright. But I think we could do that. Let's go with that. And we have, yes, that's about right. That's about the colour we need. Darker colours with the guttering, we'll deal with that in a minute. But let's get these boards down. my cobalt blue, but I put a little bit of Payne's grey with it. So I want to strengthen that a little bit there. I think these all could do with a little bit more intensity. And particularly under here, we have the guttering, which was and this facing board here. Make sure we've got a nice bit of colour on that. You don't have to be absolutely faithful to the photograph. It's only there as a reference. But it's nice to take from it what you like. Different colours. And guttering coming along there. I'll darken up a bit. Payne's grey there. Along that edge, this bit of shadow. Dark under there. Dark in that window. This solar eye will peer into it. And this other edge as well. Brickwork. Tiles. I'll try and capture some of that. More continuous lines. Called lost and found elements of it show. Try and suggest individual tiles, but not to be too repetitive though. Can't fill in everyone. Hard to hint at the glass. Dab in the side of your brush to kind of suggest the shapes. Slightly dry brush. Sometimes give you some suggestion of the brick. Yes, they were definitely a lot darker down here. What about, let's get a little bit of green going in there to create a little bit of this greenery which we've got. Put a bit of yellow ochre in it as well. That can vary the green. And a little bit of blue can I'll try and put in some colours as well. Were a few plants here. There's a little one there, a little shrub, and a nice, lovely red flower on that in a minute, which I'm going to try and do. And over that windowsill, we had lots of colourful plants coming as well there. There were some yellows in here as well. Just split your brush like this. Break the ends up a little bit and give you a more broken colouring. Thinner little marks. I have some coming in here. Right. Now I need to put some get some more bricky colour, I think, in there. Let's go for a bit of umber this time. This one. Burnt umber. Mix a little bit of light red with it. That's a bit too strong, so tone it down with a little neutral colour. Oh, I've got some Payne's grey there. That will take it down a bit. Yes, Payne's grey. And yes, I think that helps me a little bit. That a little bit of brickwork down there, and this side, I think, of that window. I'm going to introduce a bit there. I don't want this. I mean, my door rather too big, so I'm just going to square it. down a little bit. Reduce it by introducing some of my brick there. And you see it behind this gate as well. Use this colour I've got on my palette at the moment to sweep in this pathway. Great glaring bit of white here. I'll leave the little bits to show, and also you have some stones here, some flagstones, I've got a few there, I think we'll have another one here as well. Planter. Let's put something there. Let's change the tone up a bit. So we've got something that stands out a little bit. Bit of ochre there. Right. And I need to indicate that window a little bit, indicating the windows here. And indicate the wall here. The entrance, I think it is a doorway there, yes. It is, and I'll bring the edge of this wall down a little bit there. Dark in there so that we've got a suggestion of a doorway. So again, for a bit of umber, a bit of Payne's grey. Don't want to use black straight out of the pot because it will be too dark. Yes, that'll do it. Payne's grey and a bit of blue coming down here, and I want some more darks in there. Darks up there. A in there. Really, don't we? I need a nice blue, a nice palish blue. I want to put into this now. Also, the window frames, let's beef up the blue a little bit though. If we're gonna have a blue, we might as well make a nice blue. That actually in there was a bit more, and again down here. Right. Yes. These windows. The frames were like this too. Little features don't have to be absolutely accurate to the reference, but if it works, if it can add something to your picture, then why not? I think I need to put some somewhat darker, indicate those windows. This door needs to be a bit darker. Indicate the doorway. Right, let us get some suggestion of the gate. Let's get a nice blue going for the gate. What do I want? I've got a nice phthalo blue. Strengthen that. Right. Now, what I do, I've got to get those little tables in, haven't I? There as well, to give us the lightness that we need. Ooh, they're all cut out, sort of like wrought iron work. Right. And this one too. That was a nice curve. I got some little filigree things cut into the tables. A bit dark under there as well. We have some shadow. So come around like that. Right, just using that terracotta or Indian red colour that I've got to give a bit of texture to these brickwork. let's try and add some shape to that in a minute. Let that dry off a bit. I think this needs to be a darker, a little bit of ultramarine. Let's dull it down, put a bit of umber. That's better. Too many whites showing through there, so I've had to vary that a little bit, try and knock them back a bit. Enough variety in that green there. Looking a bit flat. Let's put again a little bit more dark in there. Usually a plant, any structure will have darker colours to the bottom because it's not getting so much light. You want to create some more form. You need to have some darks to the bottom or some variety of tones. I think I need to emphasize that arch there. I need to, I got the darks enough. Dark more on there. Right. why don't I see if I can do something with this sign. Again, I'm just using my number 8 round. Could have gone a bit smaller, I suppose. But it is fairly multi-purpose. We haven't done enough over that shade over there. Then we have another scroll, bit of ironwork here, and it's anchored here, and it's held. Trying to create that sign, and then I've got to try and write the cobbles on it. I think under that windowsill would be a bit darker too. That's right, and the windows are not dark. Make it read well. Right, does that read a little better? Darker down in there. The door there, I think. Right. Right, and just along here, they've got a lovely pot of flowers, a hanging basket. So I think I want to get a little bit of green in there, and then we can put a nice bit of red to represent the flowers. So let's get, it's a fairly bright green. So if I stipple it in here a little bit. OK. keep it fairly light. A nice conical basket. Hanging below it, so let me leave it at that. I could put some colours in here as well, actually. I think there were some nice colours. Right. Don't overdo it, boy, don't overdo it. So I've got to put some, so I can get that shape. Right. Yes, I need that, let that dry a little bit. But have I got this dark enough? So this be a bit darker. Let me see. What colour is it? Sort of. Let's go wild and put a different base, a bit of a red in the brown. See if that can add something. Yes, I think it can. Gotta try and keep interest. Any expanse of surface. It's a bit boring if it's all the same. Yet I'm trying to create some thing that suggests cobbles. A little flint. I think lots of flint. Pebbles. This is rye. If you've never been to Rye, I'm going to make a visit. Very ancient. Interesting place. Got some lovely little hotels in the high street, which I've stayed at. Just really lovely. Do my little conical. Hanging basket up here in a minute, but I'm not sure it's totally dry yet. So let's try and create some cobbles. On the side of this path. shadow under the bottom there, under the gate. Right. Right, let's have a go at putting that little flower basket in. So I think I'm going to go for a much, somewhat smaller brush here, yes. I've got a little number 5 round, quite a nice point on it. And I think I need a little light browny colour to make my nice conical shape there. And with somewhat darker brown, a little drier perhaps. I've got more control. I can, yes, that's what I need to do. Make a little try and create a little conical shape. I think we can make it a little bigger actually. Well, I've got this little fine point on this. I can perhaps tighten up on some of these hanging tiles. Right. Oh, I got it. I can improve the shape, I think, of my chimney somewhat. Comes out a little bit like that. Right. Perhaps I've got to have a little go at my sign writing now. I'm not so sure how good that's going to be. Let's have a go. Cobbles tea room. Yes. Built 1826. Could be earlier than that, actually. Yes, I think it was 1826. Goodness me. That is some age. I think I need a little support there as well. And I got some decorative display on there. Under the sash, there's a bit of shadow. I can do that along here. More shadow. And the same up here. You can go on doing lots and lots of detail, but it's sometimes counterproductive to do too much. It's nothing for the viewer to puzzle over and contemplate. So I think you've got to know when to stop. But that is nothing new. This one actually got a little aerial. Like that. Now let's get a bit, while we're at it, let's get some red into that. So I can put some lovely, lovely flower on it. What about this? I think this is a nice, nice red. And we've got several places actually where we can put some red. Have some flowers down there. We have a lot of flowers here. And I'm really anxious to get these in this hanging basket. I can really set it off with a nice bit of colour there. And as I said here, definitely have some down there. And I mustn't overdo it though. and make a bit more flower shape perhaps on that one. I could introduce some other colours as well. I think I might do that. Well, we've got, it is a summery day. So let's get a nice creamy cadmium yellow. I can just mix it up enough so it's really intense, because this, they definitely had some few around here too. Yep, there were scouts on her. I remember seeing them. Oh, didn't mean to do that. A little colour there. And right, what about putting a bit of, yes, there were sort of pinky flowers in there as well. Let's see if I get some pinky flowers. How do we do that? Bit of red, dilute it a little bit. Yeah, I think that's quite pinky. And where did I see that? Right, they look a little bit. I'll put some blue as well. It was a colourful display, I remember. Yes, I think there's a bit of a crease along there. Show the darkness along there. Now it's dark under here. You like it, really. I like a balance of realism, but I also like a little impressionism as well. So there you go. This is a little struggle. Right. Have we done enough? I think they've got a number along here. Ooh, I tell you what, they have got just about here. Got a beautiful lamp. Beautiful shape of a lamp. So I must try and capture that. Gorgeous thing. Like a coaching lamp suspended. I'm not sure how it's, I see it's sticking out of the wall. Right, so we'll paint it in just here. Support there. There it is. And it's coming on a bracket from there. So I think I should leave it at that. Could be a little longer. Yeah, that's it. Right, let's leave it at that. I think I had some lovely roses there. Lovely yellow roses. Okay, well, we'll leave that at that, I think. There were pots on there. It's a bit too dark. Right, yeah. Yep. Okay, well, I think I'm going to call a halt there. And here's my little, the Cobbles Tea Room in Rye, down in Sussex. Absolutely gorgeous place to visit. You really have a lovely day there, but make sure you go and have a nice cream tea in the Cobbles. I don't think you'll be disappointed. Here's the finished article. Try to get a bit of a balance of detail. And also to capture the atmosphere, impressionism.